I'm Lauren, and I'm a rising sophomore at Castilea, and this is my Blue Stain journey. Alrighty, so this was kind of the theme of my 6 weeks here at Blue Stamp. I actually had 3 projects. 2 of them did not work, so I'm going to go through all of them today. My beginning project, my first project, was battery charging shoes. And so the first way I generated energy was with piezoelectric elements. And basically, piezoelectric elements are crystals, and when applied pressure, they output a voltage. Sadly, the piezoelectric elements did not produce enough current to actually charge a battery sufficiently, but I was able to light an LED or some other type of light. So I had to start over. And I was thinking of other ways to generate energy, and I was thinking of, have you guys ever seen those like shake flashlights where you shake them? Yeah. So I started to use that, which is actually inductive charging. And so I made my first prototype of that, which this is basically just PVC pipe. It has magnetic wire coiled around it, and I actually did this one by hand, which took forever. And then it has a magnet that goes through, and when you shake it, it produces voltage. Sadly, this did not produce as much voltage as I wanted, so I had to make another prototype. And this is the bigger, better version. And I basically 3D printed the 2BC here, and then I coiled the wire. This time, not doing it by hand, I used a drill to do it a little better. But I still didn't get enough charge to actually charge a battery the way I wanted to. And it would actually take 3,000 hours to charge an iPhone this way. So, I was like, no way, I can't do that. So, and then I had to start over. And I had a week left, and so I decided, hey, let me just do a fun project. So I decided to take the piezoelectrics and just have it so that when you tap, it makes a tone. I was able to play some parts of Star Wars, but it kind of fell out. But now I can play a tone for you, so. Wait, so yeah. Yeah. And so what I learned from this is that, especially for piezoelectrics, as I said, they're not really used for charging, they're more of used for sensing, so that's why I used it in this project to sense the touch and then play the sound. So. And I also learned a lot about inductive charging, and I learned that normally for manufacturing these coils, there are usually machines that do this, and I researched a lot about that, looked at videos, they're so mesmerizing just seeing the coil go. And
yeah, so thank you.
Oh, questions.
So it seems like you went through a lot of different iterations of a bunch of different stuff. How do you keep track of it all and remember what worked and what didn't work and the pros and cons of each?
So I wrote everything down in my project book, and everything I learned, like every single thing I looked up, I put a link there, and every day I wrote about what my goal was, what I was going to do tomorrow, what I did today, and just so I can keep track of all that.
First of all, hats off to your strength and perseverance. I'm a fan. My question is, can we do something to increase or decrease the volume of that speaker? A simple solution to do that?
Well, in fact, when I was playing my Star Wars music earlier on in the week, it was extremely loud, so I just decided, well, why don't I put a resistor on it? And it actually, I thought it would change the tone, maybe change the pitch a little bit, but no, it just made it softer.
for the piezos, did you test them by like tapping them with your hand, or like did you actually like step on them?
I found that like stepping on them isn't as great. It's better when it's an applied pressure in a small area. So I used a pen or like something like a needle type thing to do it. So ideally, I guess for a shoe, it wouldn't be that great, but it can't generate power, that much power anyway, so.
So what did you learn about the instructables that people sometimes post on the internet?
There were so many people, at least for the piezoelectrics, there were so many people that I'd seen that they had won awards for their project, and they had done all this stuff, but it like following their instructions exactly, the project didn't work, and they would say like, it didn't work as well, which in reality it didn't work at all. So you just kind of have to comb through them, try to find, I think at least if you're looking for people on the internet, find as many that say find multiple people that say one thing instead of just one person, because that's what a lot of people were saying, that this stuff would work, and lo and behold, not so much.